another exclusive Pathé sporting feature reporting the international tournament, United States Armed Forces versus the British Army, with the takings turned over to the Red Cross. I went with our cameramen to the Albert Hall, anticipating some good fighting. I wasn't disappointed. But with at least half of the 5,000 other onlookers, I was puzzled by the American rules under which the contests were fought and judged. When Cyril Galley for the British Army met Bill Garrett, the triple Golden Gloves winner and the only coloured fighter in the US team, the British welterweight had to try to catch up on a 2-1 lead which the Americans then had over the British. In my opinion, it was the best fight of the evening. It was real solid punching, with both lads packing vicious left and right swings. Garrett clinched a bit too often, but the three rounds were loaded with action. A strange anomaly, but this fighting made you forget the war for a while. Every one of those swings carried dynamite. If they had connected, one or other would have been out in the taxi rank. End of the first round, and I fancied Galley's chances over his Pennsylvanian opponent. Mary Churchill seemed really excited too. Round two, and Galley came in fighting strongly. Here was a chance, I thought, to even things up. But I was to learn not to draw my own conclusions as to the likely winner. The American judges knew better. A hefty right from Galley, and although the pace was beginning to tell, there was still a lot of danger in every punch. I was interested to see that while the seconds in the British corner fanned with towels, at no time did the Americans do this. Round three saw the two contestants working hard for a decision. A few seconds to go and Garrett went into a clinch. I plumped for a narrow points victory for Galley, but like Pantelleria, I surrendered to superior judgment when Garrett carried the fight. By the time the 11th and last bout came round, I was ready for anything to happen. It started with a mistaken idea by somebody that Preston, the Britisher, was wearing 6-ounce instead of 8-ounce gloves. It was all straightened out, and the two heavyweights, Preston and Kozak, came together. Preston in the white shorts is a burly commando. Those muscular arms and great shoulders of his got me counting on a deciding win for the British Army. There was little pretense of science, just two great giants with a load of responsibility. Referee Widmer prized them apart, and the two men mountains began tearing and bashing into each other. With both men practically worn to a standstill, we waited for the final gong. When it came, referee Widmer picked up a gum shield which had been knocked out, and like the voice of doom came the decision. Kozak was the winner, and the match to America by 6-5. Well, I don't understand American football either, but it was a darn good evening.